Donald Fagen and Snowbound. All right, I'm sure you know Phil Collins is back with a new album. And if you want to see him live in 1994, here are the details. On April the 4th, he kicks off with a show at the Stockholm Globe. Then on the 6th, he moves on to Oslo at the Spectrum. Utrecht is the next stop. That's on April the 9th at the Prins van Oranje Hall. Then on the 15th, he plays the first of two dates at Dortmund's Westfalenhalle. And finally, Phil stops off at the Galaxy in Metz on April the 21st. Crowded House continue their tour with a show at the Zurich Volkshaus on December the 13th. Then on the 14th, it's Geneva at the Palladium. Milan's Zimba Club is the place to be on the 15th. Then on the 17th, it's Erlangen at the Ewerk. And the tour winds up at the Paris Bataclan on December the 19th. Deborah Harry plays London's Hammersmith Apollo on the 4th. Then on the 6th, it's Cardiff at the St. David's Hall. Payton is the place to be on the 7th when Deborah treads the boards at the Festival Theatre. And then on the 8th, it's all happening at Crawley's Leisure Hall. And finally, you can catch the former Blondie frontwoman live at the Birmingham Symphony Hall in December, on December the 9th. Okay, that's it for tour news today. Up next, it's the latest headlines from the news team.
The Red Hot organisation, which raises money for AIDS research through sales of benefit albums, has recently released their third album, No Alternative. The album includes previously unreleased songs by 21 bands, including Nirvana and Soul Asylum. R.E.M. and former 10,000 Maniacs vocalist Natalie Merchant have recorded a song together for an LP that backs women's rights to choose on the issue of abortion. Other artists featuring on the LP, Born to Choose, are Tom Waits, Sugar and the Cowboy Junkies. The album features both original material and covers of famous songs like the Beatles' She Said, She Said. Outspoken British rap act Fundamental are currently creating a stir on the airwaves with their new single, Countryman. And they're also in the midst of a legal battle. Two members of the band left the group and now there's a dispute over who can actually use the name Fundamental. That's it for the Coke headlines and now it's back to Marina.
Back to the music now with the latest release from Paul Weller. Now Paul, of course, began his career in the music business when he formed The Jam in the mid-70s. Mod Roots, The Jam's attitude found favour with punks at the time and they went on to become one of the biggest selling single bands of the decade. Surprisingly, at the peak of their popularity, Paul decided to call it a day and by 1982, The Jam were no longer. Now he resurfaced a year later with the Style Council and formed Red Wedge, a politically motivated group of musicians who toured Britain and raising money for various causes. Well, after a relatively dry period over the past couple of years, Paul's back with a new band, a new tour, and a new EP. See what you think? The Weaver.